glad to be here, and I'm very much honored to open up this whole foundation that really is your recommendation, and hopefully will help to serve many, many patients along the years. And I have been doing liver transplants since 1989, and I have met and got involved in the treatment of many patients, and I was very honored to see some people from the past, actually, that were here, and I was able to see them that they are doing very well. But everybody in our lives leaves some impression on us, and liver transplant is, as one of my colleagues, Dr. Warren Kaur, says, it's like an addiction. You know, once you do liver transplant, you can't do without, you know, liver transplant, because it becomes a significant bonding between the physician and the patient, and constant trust. And this becomes almost like a family event, family environment. The team that you work with is amazingly cohesive. Anything and everything is important. Right now, we are here, we're going to enjoy this event, but our hearts are with Clark and I, you know, meeting, because our, some members of our team is, you know, working and doing a liver transplant as we speak on the table. So this thing is a lifelong event. The hero of tonight, not only by putting this foundation, but with her beautiful voice, is willing to do the fundraising, is Deborah Perioli. And again, among many people I have met, she's a very, very special person. Deborah got an illness that she didn't have any liver disease before, called acute liver failure. And some of you may have had a similar event and would remember how quickly one gets sick. And the symptoms of liver failure is not really a very difficult thing. It could be just fatigue, it could be just nausea, vomiting, abdominal pain. But regardless of this, it's a very fast progressive, you know, illness. And the majority of the time, we really don't have a whole lot of time to help the patient and find out more what she is. And Deborah is definitely a person like this that I never got to know before transplant. She was very quickly comatose, and she got to the level where if we didn't have the liver, we were very, very lucky to get this, that she wouldn't be here today. And the liver came in right on time for her. It was an amazing, you know, rescue. And her brain got swollen so much so that we had to put a monitor to monitor brain pressures. And usually these monitors are unfortunately used to make sure somebody is not brain dead. So it's not really very, very helpful in monitoring the treatment, because if the brain swells from liver failure, there's very little that we could do to reduce it backwards. In her case, it was incredibly important, because during the surgery, they had to do her at 45 degrees, almost like an upright, close to upright position, because when they were to lay her down, the pressures were going up and blood perfusion to the brain was basically cutting off. And so it was an amazing surgery, it was amazing anesthesia. Again, another team member that came with us. And she survived. What made her very, very special, and I will never forget this, is that I was the first person telling her that she's alive and well, but with a little bit of a casualty, that she has a new liver that she didn't expect to have. And amazingly well, she embraced this thing, and she said that if I am meant to be alive, then I will spend the rest of my life helping people so that they can get the same thing. It's amazing how, you know, receiving immediately turned, in her case, to the giving. Before the event, she left the hospital. She very quickly grasped a situation that I don't think I could have, as a person working in this, is where you have to go through the denial, anger, all that. There was nothing like that. She just moved right to the acceptance phase. So, it is my great honor to introduce her with her beautiful voice. And again, we didn't hear her speak before the transplant. She was comatose. But I was able to hear her, but this will be my first time to actually hear her sing. And so I'm looking forward to it.
You might want to ask my husband for the rest of the story. fortunate to be here, and it's because of my wonderful doctors and the team, and as Dr. Villiers said, the family of doctors and nurses, transplant coordinators, everyone. It's just, I find myself in a whole new world of care that I'm deeply thankful for, and I know that I speak for my husband as well. I'm also thankful to have with me my wonderful friends and colleagues this evening. My good friend Tom, who is here from New Jersey, where I grew up. I'm so glad to be here to share in this. This is my first performance back, and I couldn't do it without him. And our wonderful pianist, Amanda Riggers.
Trees of green, green roses too. Dei fat valore amoroso, non ti giorno ogni torno girando, nelle belle tuo bando è riposo, Narcisa tuo arcino amorfo. Nelle belle tuo bando è riposo, Narcisa tuo arcino amorfo. Fra guerrieri ho formato, Stati stretto sacco, scopo in spalla, sciame in fianco, coro cinto, muso franco, un gran casco, un gran turbante, un globo cantante, globo cantante, globo cantante.
Lord, she got a mango.
Heartbreaking story. But They want me to sing a little something. And they've actually created this position for me. They've never had a runner-up before. And I'm so honored, honestly. I'm deeply honored. But I thought, well, what can I sing? I have 3 minutes to speak and sing. Dr. Cooley said that I could speak first and then sing because nobody could stop me once I started singing. However, it's not always true. So I thought I would sing something short like that aria, O mio babbino caro, which everyone knows, right? You've heard the tune, right?
Yeah.
So if you don't know it from the context of the opera or having sung it yourself, you've probably heard it on a pasta commercial. It's not really appropriate for pasta, however. Because the words at the end are, oh Dio, vorrei morir. Do you know what that means? I want to die. And Dr. Azzolatti says, vivi ancora, vivi ancora, live, living alive again, right, forever. And there's a beautiful aria that he's always been mentioning to me, La Mamma Morta. Again, there's the word morta, dead. However, this is opera. We're talking opera. Somebody's always dying. And at any rate, what do you think? Should I sing O mio babbino caro for the American Liver Foundation folks next week? Thanks for helping me. Okay. If this might be a good time, if anyone would like to take a few moments to refresh a drink, to grab a few more nibbles, we'll take a little pause, maybe a 5 minutes, so don't get too engrossed in the tables over there. Which is a wonderful spread, thanks to Dr. Kulik very much. Okay, let's take a 5, and then we'll come right back. Thank you.
Thank you.
Fly to her side and make her Yeah.
that's a great segue to explain how my life is intertwined with Deb. So I met Deb last March, when she was so sick. She was transferred into another hospital, and I met her on a Sunday evening, and she's very ill at that point, confused, cheerful, sick, and fatigued. And I think the next day we did a lot of tests. The second day in the hospital, she was requiring a mechanical ventilation to help her breathe. She was so sick. She was on a ventilator. And I think her liver came the day after that, or within a day or two of that mechanical ventilation, the ventilator supports. This was a very quick worsening of her health and requiring a transplant. And she's come back from all that so quickly. It's been amazing. In fact, so this other neat interaction or intertwining in our lives happened within about 3 months after her transplant. I took my children to the Rocky Mountain Children's Theater Camp, and here's Deb at the piano as music director. And it's an amazing experience. Children play piano and sing with China. There's so many neat parts here tonight, people represented that a lot of our liver transplant team here. So there's Adriana's here, Nicole, some of these folks, put your hands up. Sue Nelson's here. And there's also people from the Donor Alliance here tonight, which, so we've got, Linda C. is here, and Danielle, first floor here tonight, represented. Nancy Steinfurth is here from Liver Health Connection, another really neat organization in town that helps people learn more about their liver. Initially, it was a hepatitis C connection, so it's a more generalized situation to help people understand about liver health, so neat organizations. And the American Liver Foundation is represented as well. That's Danielle, that's here tonight from American Liver Foundation, who's actually celebrating Deb's story again with her the American Liver Foundation banquets this week on the 7th, and Deb will be singing at the event she mentioned. So a lot of thank yous to all these different people that have helped support the event tonight. Thank you to everybody who's here. It's really a neat way to celebrate Deb's story. Also, this is Donate Life Month. So, I mentioned we had a flag-raising ceremony for liver donors at Presbyterian St. Luke's Hospital a few days ago. But part of this is bittersweet. We have to celebrate and pay recognition and respect to the donors. For the gift they've given, respect them and their families, and really be cognizant of pain and suffering that allow these transplants to happen, and allow people to go on and give them a sense of hope and all the the deep stories and inspiring ways that we do celebrate life through transplant. It's an amazing thing to be part of. So I wanted to mention that. So part of the teams here, several of the team are in the operating room now doing actual liver transplant. So Dr. Heffern, Dr. Asalati, Dr. Lynn are all in the operating room as we speak, and they love to be here on the program, but they won't be able to because of that. Well, that's actually what I wanted to say tonight. Again, thank you all for being here. It's really a neat event to be part of. Thank you.
our program, Dr. Azzolati was going to say a few words about the importance of organ donors. And we have a short video to show you that he really wanted to share with you. And although we wish he were here with us, we're really glad he's in surgery. because he's excellent.
There's those two Italian greyhounds that are his family in a trio. And he asked me to show this tonight with the dog and this beautiful video. He's very fond of this and showed it to us. We thought it would fit well with tonight's performance. And thanks for being part of it.
Oh.
So the main reason we're here is for this foundation, Liver, High Plains Liver Foundation. So we notice in our transplant practice that it's hard for people to come to Denver and have a liver transplant for their family, or for the patient, obviously, to go through all this. It's very hard just financially for them to be in a lot of times a different city, with patients probably in the West, Western states, but for them to come to Denver and have housing, family oftentimes needs to stay with the patient 2 weeks, a month, maybe more, near the transplant center. And you know, it's expensive for housing, transportation, food, medications. And there are assistance programs, and actually Sue Wilson on our team has gotten grants for our patients for housing. It's really amazing. We wanted to try to have another resource for our patients to have more financial support for this. So that's where the idea of this foundation started, I think. And Deb's wanted to give towards this and give back to this. I think a lot of it was her idea. The name, having a gala here tonight, this really is Deb's work. This is a lot of her idea to put this together. We went back and forth different names. Luckily, I know an intellectual property lawyer who named Ian O'Neill, who's here tonight. He's with Ronstein, Thayer, Farber, and Schreck. I got them all. I told Ian we'd like to have a foundation for this. And he said, well, what name are you going to pick? I'm going to make sure nobody else is using that name. So we went Rocky Mountain Foundation, Liver Foundation. But that was. And there's probably 10 other foundations involved in the title, so you may be aware of that. And then at the same time, Deb came up with High Plains Foundation, a Clint Eastwood fan, High Plains group. Ray came up with the name, it's a fantastic name.
I just searched High Plains online, and it's the region of the patients that you're covering.
It's perfect, yeah, Montana
down to
New Mexico. So it's really nice. Deb chose the name and it's worked. There's a High Plains Foundation that protects prairies up in Loveland. Ian found out for us. So I called them to make sure they're okay with us. Also, having a very similar name, they seem to be okay with it. So that's where the High Plains Foundation's come from. So we're very happy to have your support for this tonight. It'll go towards helping patients really to stay in town here, close to their, for patients' families to stay close to them with housing and also transportation support for them. So it'll add more flexibility for our patients. And do you want to say a few words?
Oh boy.
And also, I just forgot to thank my beautiful wife, Kristen Doan, and actually, yeah. So, you know, worked hard to have jobs and three kids and amazing things here. But it's taking great communication and a strong love for us to be able to keep the ball rolling. And I just want to appreciate her.
Did all of this, all the refreshments, which is just really generous, and thank you. And I have lots of people helping tonight, so thank you to all of your help. Especially to this venue, who has donated the use of the building for us, so we appreciate that very much. And as I admire this lovely backdrop of the organ facade, I wonder who donated their organ. Oh my God. You know, post-liver transplant, there's a lot of things you can't do like you used to. I can't still sit up on my own without rolling first. I don't know, maybe I used to roll anyway. I just feel it more now. And can't do certain things. You know, the liver is like an amazing, giant, mysterious organ. I named mine Alice, I don't know why. Alice in Wonderland, maybe. And so you can't do things that like you used to, like smoke cigars. Those days are over. You can't drink things like tequila, vodka, or wine, or beer, or pretty much anything fun. Gone, days are behind me. Can't eat raw things. Yeah, no more chicken tartare. I have to have my pork well done now. But, you know, there's one thing that can't do without.
These are really
Sabalik, here's one of our patients waiting. Joanne Mitchell, she's here. Joanne's here. She brought these for, and donated these to the foundation. So if anybody's interested in you know, don't make a donation for one of these pieces, please feel free to do that. The ones on the top especially are called Tree of Life, and you have to ask Joanne that they have symbolism to each of the layers in the different parts. And she's hand collected the pieces from here in Colorado and put them together to help celebrate this evening. So thanks again to Joanne.
Not to worry, whistle on.